Proceeds from today's event will support Seniors in Crisis, a program that delivers much needed assistance to seniors who are unable to financially look after their needs. So we want to ask all of you with us today, especially the young sports fans, to please not approach our guests for autographs during the event. This interferes with the flow of what we're trying to do, and it makes it difficult for the presentations, and we'll have plenty of time for autographs at the end.
Nous avons plusieurs invités spéciaux avec nous aujourd'hui. Sans plus tarder, nous voudrions vous les présenter. Je vous invite bien sûr à surveiller leur entrée par la porte arrière ainsi que sur nos écrans géants. Accueillons maintenant notre invité d'honneur accompagné par les copromoteurs de l'événement, Michael Wagon et Bram Namer, Monsieur Roy Solomon. Please welcome today's guest of honor, accompanied by event co-chairs Michael Wagon and Bram Namer, Mr. Roy Solomon. Je vous invite maintenant à accueillir notre personnalité sportive de l'année. Let's now welcome our very special sports personality of the year. He is the executive director of the NHL Players Association and a proud member of the American Jewish community, Mr. Donald Fehr, accompanied by our honorary event chairman, Morden Cooking Lazarus.
Gentlemen, let's hear it for the first Jewish mayor in the history of Montreal. Let's get him to run again, Mayor Michael Applebaum. The member for the National Assembly for Darcy McGee, he's still our Minister of Jewish Affairs, Lawrence Bergman. Our member of Parliament for Mount Royal, the Federal Minister of Jewish Affairs, Erwin Kotler.
Le Consul Général pour Israël, the Consul General for Israel, Joel Leon.
Ladies and gentlemen, today we are honoring the 1993 Stanley Cup Montreal Canadiens, and Charles is going to introduce a legend who will help us with the introduction.
Yes, Mike, to help us with the introduction of these 1993 Stanley Cup champions, the great broadcaster, who was indeed there covering the game on June 9, 1993, 20 years ago, when Montreal defeated the Los Angeles Kings, please welcome the legendary Dick Irvin.
Good morning, everybody.
It's my distinct pleasure to introduce some fine gentlemen to join the already fine gentlemen who have been introduced. And 1993 is 20 years ago. 20 years ago. But who knows? Things are looking up. But 1993 was a very special year. I've broadcast the Montreal Canadiens for 33 years, and it's one of the years that really stands out. So we're going to start off not only with the fellow who coached the team, but he's going to carry the Stanley Cup. He's now a senator. He's now a senator. My father won 4 Stanley Cups. He never became a senator. I don't know. But Jacques Demers did, and deservedly so. Ladies and gentlemen, the man who led the team to the Stanley Cup in 1993 with the Stanley Cup. Here is Senator Jacques Demers.
Yeah.
from Jacques later on. So, relax. Coach. I don't know whether to call him coach or senator now. That's very confusing. A few years ago, I was one of the MCs privileged to be at the YMHA Hall of Fame ceremony. And that evening, they inducted Cecil Hart, who coached the Canadians in 1930 and 1931 for two Stanley Cup winners. Cecil Hart was the first and I think maybe the only Jewish coach who's ever won a Stanley Cup. A couple of Jewish players, one named Alex Levinsky, have their name in the Stanley Cup before 1993, but I think that Matthew Snyder is the only Jewish hockey player for the Montreal Canadiens. We're not sure about that. Matthew himself couldn't even tell me for sure this morning that he's the only one who has his name on the cup. But he certainly does from 1993. He's now working for the NHL. Matthew Snyder coming in with the Prince of Wales trophy for the first place team. Matthew, from the 1993 Stanley Cup winning Canadiens. In 1992-93, a very fine little guy from Russia made his National Hockey League debut with the Montreal Canadiens, playing briefly in both the regular season and in the playoffs. The following year, he was voted to the NHL All-Rookie Team. He was the first Russian player in the lineup of the Montreal Canadiens, and he's carrying the Conn Smythe trophy in that was won in 93 by Patrick Roy. So he's become a Montrealer, lives in Beaconsfield. Let's welcome Oleg Petrov. Pretty good names on there from the Canadian. John Beliveau was the first winner of that trophy. Now it's my pleasure to introduce a gentleman who has kept the team together in a different way than coaches and players do, but in a very important way. He's the chief physician for the Montreal Canadiens for many years. He's Dr. David Mulder of the Montreal General Hospital. I like to call him Dr. Dr. Mulder from Eston, Saskatchewan, which isn't far from where Scott Flory and I grew up in Regina. But he's been a wonderful addition to the Canadiens for so many years, and he's a wonderful person. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. David Mulder of the Montreal Canadiens. Our next former Montreal Canadian is now giving his hockey expertise, and it is he's got a lot of it, on the radio broadcasts of the Canadiens' games, home and away. He wore number 36 when he played for the Montreal Canadiens. Ladies and gentlemen, Sergio Mameso. Career in professional hockey, he has retired. A very well-respected member of the National Hockey League. When he played for the Canadiens, which was a period of three seasons, he wore number 52, and he's a Montrealer through and through. Ladies and gentlemen, Matthew Darche. And finally, for me, we like to say that the tradition continues in the broadcast booth. And for the last couple of seasons, we have all enjoyed listening on TSN 690 now to the Canadiens, home and away. The play-by-play man, I don't know how many public appearances he's made in this city, but here's one for sure, and he's doing a great job. John Bartlett. John? There's John.
Ladies and gentlemen, another hand for the legendary Dick Irvin.
Également avec nous ce matin, quelques représentants des Alouettes de Montréal. Je voudrais vous les présenter. À commencer par le président du conseil d'administration, Chairman of the Board, a proud member of our Jewish community, Paul Harris. Il est le plus grand passeur de tous les temps. Un futur membre du Temple de la Renommée. He is the all-time passing leader and future Hall of Famer. Le numéro 13, number 13, quarterback Anthony Calvillo. He's the guy that Anthony is probably very happy not to face every now and then, but the other quarterbacks are not that fortunate. Ligne défensive toute étoile, John Bowman.
Next in the lineup, tackle Josh Bork. And here's a man who had a chance to go back and play for his native Saskatchewan Roughriders, and he said, no, I like Montreal better. It's guard Scott Flory. The legendary number 74. He looks like he could still get out there and catch a few passes. Peter Dallariva. We also want to acknowledge the presence today of Denver Reed and Alexandre Marceau from the Alouettes head office, who've been very, very helpful in getting us guests. And Denver Reed is helpful to all community organizations in getting guests for their events. So thank you very much for being here and for your help. From the Montreal Expos, his mission is to bring baseball back to Montreal. He believes we will have a professional baseball team in Montreal again. Number 49, Warren Cromartie.
And he's got the springtime blues real bad. Can't help but reminisce about the great years she had. I remember Fuller's 83 summer. Yes, we had to pick up my pops.
Warren, keep walking towards Michael Applebaum. The mayor is standing up. He is cheering. I think Michael Applebaum wants a new stadium. What a campaign. Media, listen. Will Michael Applebaum build a new stadium for baseball? We'll ask him later.
Un releveur qui remporte le Cy Young, ça n'arrive pas souvent, et celui que je suis sur le point de vous présenter aura sans l'ombre d'un doute été le meilleur joueur de baseball de l'histoire du Québec. The Cy Young Award winner for the Los Angeles Dodgers, and without a doubt, the best professional baseball player to ever come out of Quebec, Eric Game Over Gagné.
I think if the Expos had a player like Eric Gagné, they would never have left Montreal. We called him the Spaceman. You can hear him weekdays on TSN 690 with Mitch Melnick, the one and only Bill Lee.
Rock and roll was being born, marijuana we would store. Down on the corner, the national pastime. Where...
Ladies and gentlemen, we now move to the media. The legendary hockey writer from the Montreal Gazette and the Montreal Star, making his first appearance after retiring after 58 years covering the Canadiens. Let's hear it for the legendary Red Fisher.
Welcome back. That same old place that you laughed about.
Also from the Montreal Gazette, senior columnist Dave Stobbs, football, boxing, and soccer reporter and a member of our committee, my dear friend Herb Zerkowski.
Joining us here from CTV Sports, he has to leave to go to the Impact game, but he's here with us and he'll have his report on tonight, Andre Corbet from CTV. joining him, also headed to the Impact game from CJAD, Rick Moffitt. And already seated, he'll be hosting the locker room tonight. Listen tonight at CJD. What time is it on at Abe?
6 o'clock.
6 o'clock. Listen to the locker room all about this event. The great Abe Hefter. We now move over to TSN 690. By this year, next time, TSN 690 and CJD may be in the same family. The host of the Montreal Forum and the Del Mar post-game show, Tony Marinaro. The chairman of Expos Nation with over 155,000 fans on Facebook, a nice Jewish boy from Cone St. Luke. The host of Game Points, Matthew Ross. Another nice Jewish boy from TSN 690 hosts the Kaufman Show on Monday nights, Dave Kaufman. And the co-host of the Del Mar post-game show on TSN 690, Connor McKenna. Television network set to debut in local programming in May, and a weekly sports show called Connected, City Montreal, formerly known as City TV, executive producer and content manager Bob Babinski, producer of Connected and a former world water scene champion George Athens, and Canada's most beautiful sports reporter, a former Miss Teen Canada from Rogers Sportsnet, Allison Lozoff.
The host of a weekly interview program called Scully, the world show syndicated on over 200 PBS channels across North America. Il produit présentement une série documentaire consacrée à celui que l'on surnommait affectueusement le gros Bill Jean Béliveau. Accueillons Monsieur Robert Guy Scully. He has written and will be directing a very entertaining film on the life of Bill Spaceman Lee. He also directed Holy Land Hardball, a film about the creation of a pro baseball league in Israel. Brett Rapkin.
And here broadcasting live with us at MontrealHockeyTalk.com, MontrealHockeyTalk.com. Remember the website tonight. You'll be able to hear their live broadcast on tape delay, the podcast from this event. We've got in the lobby doing their show, Ted Bird from TSN, Joey Elias, Costa Papoulias, David Kellerman, and Alex Rabat. Take a look, listen to it tonight, but young children, be careful, close your ears. Also volunteering with us today, he's doing my video right now from K103 Radio, a world champion tennis player, Zach Rath. We also have with us from the media, from the Journal de Montréal, Marc Defoy. David Lazarus from the Canadian Jewish News, Peter Kerr from the Montrealer, Mark Lidbetter from the Suburban, Michael Sokachevsky from the Suburban, Bram Eisenhall from the Local Herald, and Stuart Nullman from the West End Times. You'll notice that our volunteers are wearing, I guess they're wearing Montreal baseball shirts, Montreal Baseball Project shirts and Maccabiah shirts. They're going to be selling Montreal Baseball Project shirts. You'll be able to get autographs on them for $20 each, proceeds going to our event, so that'll be after the event. You also have raffle tickets, one for $10, three for $20. Just see the back of your program book for the fabulous prizes. And again, the Montreal Baseball Project. We have a fabulous silent auction for those of you who have not checked it out in the lobby. There's some amazing, amazing stuff. And we're going to have a live auction with Joey Elias coming up very shortly. Right now, it's my pleasure to bring up the co-chairs for the event. They've done an amazing job. The grizzled veteran, Mike Wagan, and the rookie, Bram Nehmer.